everybody. This is Kevin, the Postcard Guy, here from Sarasota, Florida, with another video on collecting old postcards. This one's going to look at some vintage motorcycle postcards, a really cool category that a lot of people collect today. Motorcycles are as popular as ever today. You see them all over the road, and people do love their Harleys and their Indians and other makes and models of motorcycles. So let's take a look back at some vintage motorcycle postcards. So we'll begin with this one here. I started from some of the earliest postcards available. This is a really nice advertising postcard that reads, "Like a Flash, Indian Motorcycle, Hendy Manufacturing Company, Springfield, Massachusetts." You have a rider there with a pair of goggles. You have him passing by a Native American Indian camp with teepees. You have an Indian up in the corner with a feather and a really early motorcycle there that on the tank, it reads Indian Motorcycles. On the back here, it is not postally used. This card I'm getting ready to put up online, but this, the last version of this card that I saw sold for about $90 or so. So this is one of the better advertising Indian motorcycle postcards. If you can find something like this, you're doing very good. Next one up is a real photo postcard. This one has two officers in uniform riding a motorcycle with a sidecar, doing some kind of acrobatics or something going on there. It does look like it is a European postcard. It is a real photo postcard, though. So a neat card there. I would expect something like this to be in the $15 to $20 range. I know a lot of you had asked, try to give some values on postcards so you have an idea on what these things sell for. This one is another real photo postcard, or RPPC. Again, real photos were made directly from a camera taking a photograph and then brought to a dark room in a photography studio and then printed onto postcard stock. So this is not a printed photograph. This is something that was developed on film in a dark room. So when you look at it, you will not see a series of dots all over the card like you will see with a printed card like the first one we looked at. So these are real photo postcards here. We have a whole family here, a couple young men, a couple young ladies there. You got a sidecar. Over on the back, what's nice is it is marked on who the people are. And with a little bit of research, I found out this is Berks County, Pennsylvania. So that's a Pennsylvania motorcycle view. This card here could be about $20 to $30, give or take. And you never know with real photos, they could go almost anywhere. This is a very early, early motorcycle postcard here. Again, an Indian motorcycle. It is chain driven. As you look here, you can see almost like a bicycle chain going around it with the motor in the middle. The early motorcycles were chain driven like this. You have a spiffy looking gentleman there. These are what they call straight handlebars here. And really, it was almost like an early bicycle with an engine on it. But this is one of the very first Indian motorcycles, probably around 1914 or so. And yes, correct, 1914. Card back talks about this is so you can see what I look like now. Kind of a neat real photo postcard. And again, dated 1914. So nice real photo postcard there. Over here, got a gentleman in a tropical type view. I would say this is either California or Florida. But again, with an Indian motorcycle, you can see as it's spelled out on the flat tank. And another chain-driven motorcycle there. Man with a tie on the motorcycle. Real photo there. And again, these can go very high, depending. You mean at auction, I've seen the real photo postcards for motorcycles go into the hundreds, depending on the make and the model and the year. That's a neat real photo there of a man on a motorcycle. Over here, this appears to be French. What I like about this is a racing motorcycle, has a number 7 in between the spokes. Got a man there wearing a beret, and this is also an Indian motorcycle here. Very neat. It does have the French postcard back, and this one has not been sent. But I came across a large lot of motorcycle postcards, so I wanted to share these with everybody while they're still all together. Here's another early Indian motorcycle, very dapper looking man with a cap, standing there with the early model Indian. I love the little license plate on the fender there. up against the brick wall, just very proudly showing off his Indian motorcycle. That one is not postally sent. Here's another person. It's either, I don't know if it's the same or a different person, but looks like the same motorcycle. This one has a number 3 on it, similar to the other one that had number 7. So I don't know if maybe these are manufacturer numbers for their models, or maybe they could be racing. I'm not quite sure, but this one is not postally sent as well. Over here's a really nice one. Oil City, looks like I.L. Jocelyn, riding from Oil City, Pennsylvania to Los Angeles. So he's going cross-country on his motorcycle there. He's got his bedroll on the back and everything he owns with him. Nice old motorcycle postcard there, not postally sent. Here you have a couple. Looks like Jip, probably Jip the dog, Kurt, and Hazel riding on the motorcycle there. I believe that's an Indian model. You could probably see that better than I can. But that is a real photo postcard. And again, a card like this could go anywhere from 20 to 50, depending on the auction. So if you see motorcycle postcards, be sure to pick them up. This is not a postcard, but a photograph that was glued into the album. But what I liked about it, it says the Indian Motorcycle 1916 model now on exhibition. Got the people sitting out front. You got the Indian sign here in the window. And it, you can see it says Motorcycle Garage. And it looks like Audubon. Audubon Motorcycle Garage. So it is almost postcard size. You can see it's just about the size of a postcard. Can't tell if it's a postcard underneath there or not, but it has been glued in. But I thought that was a really unique image there. Over here to a man on a motorcycle. Really neat early motorcycle there. Photo postcard. And over here, you got a couple on a sidecar. You got the basket there and the sidecar. Neat image there. That one is not postally used, but that is a real photo as well. Over here, you got three or so people on a motorcycle with a sidecar and a little boy. That one is not postally sent. Here's an early card here. There's a series of these. I've seen these before. A.C. Rice of the Eclipse Machine Company. So you'll see this huge, super giant motorcycle superimposed on landmarks all around cities. So it's kind of a unique old postcard there. It's an advertising postcard and dated 1911. But again, anything motorcycle related is worth taking a second look. This is a beauty here. This is a linen postcard from the 40s. Home of the world-famous Indian motorcycle, and shows the factory there, shows a 1940s model here, talks about their design, and it reads, Indian Motorcycle Company, Springfield, Massachusetts. Card is just about mint as you could be. It's got nice corners, no creases. It describes the Indian Motorcycle Company on the back. That is a beautiful card there, and just about perfect. Over here, we got another linen advertising card. This is Indian World's Finest Motorcycle. Nice motorcycle there. Leather seat, leather side bags, or what do you call those bags on the back? Saddle bags, I guess you call them. On the back, you got tons of advertising announcing the 1948 Indians featuring 19 new improvements. See them at the nearest Indian dealer, October 28th to November 1st. Arlington Circle and Sports Limited Montreal, Indian Motorcycle Distributors. And what I like is it's in French as well on the opposite side. So this is probably a Canadian Indian motorcycle postcard. Over here, this is another advertising one. This is a linen as well. Got the man with the Indian sweater on. I like that a lot. Nice early Indian motorcycle there. And on the back, you got all kinds of advertising. Again, this card should bring about $20, $25 or so. Over here, we're moving into some later cards. This is a chrome postcard here. I love the way they got the guy and the girl just cruising right along through the desert, no less. No dust, no nothing, kicking up, just riding along on a green motorcycle with saddlebags. She's wearing a totally green outfit. announcing the curtain is going up on a new 1953 Harley-Davidson. So it talks all about the advertising there. So that's a neat Harley postcard. That card probably is about $25 or so. Over here, got another chrome postcard here. This one is the, what model is that? He's a sports commentator on his Triumph motorcycle. So you got a British, I believe the British made the Triumph. And you got the advertising on the back there. Another neat bike. And coming up on this last one, another real photo postcard here. This is an unusual model called the Sunbeam. So this is a real photo advertising, like an artist rendering real photo. And that one shows the Sunbeam motorcycle. So that's just a quick look at motorcycle postcards. I hope you enjoyed seeing this video. If you did, please make sure to like and subscribe. It really does help my channel. It lets other people know that I'm out here and I'm on YouTube and I'm sharing old postcards and collecting videos. If you do like it, please make sure to like and subscribe. If you hit that little bell icon, you will be notified when my next new video comes up and it's ready to be watched. Once again, I am Kevin the Postcard Guy here in Sarasota, Florida. Just sharing some more of my neat old postcards. Thanks for watching.